I don't want to spend $1,000 popping bottles. First of all, I don't drink that much. Two drinks, I'm good. Three, I'm fucked up. I ain't gonna spend $1,000 popping bottles. Why? So me and my boys can drink? We ain't fucking. Get your own liquor, you thirsty motherfucker. Shit. Looking at me all night. Hey, Gary, you gonna get a bottle? I'm gonna get a glass. Plus, if I did want to order a bottle, I can't do it discreetly. I can't be in an iClub like, hey, man, let me get one bottle. And they slide me a bottle in the low. Nah, comes with a goddamn sparkler on it. The light show happens throughout the club. A siren goes off. Takes eight girls to bring one fucking bottle out. Like, one girl's got the bottle, one's got the sparkler. Five girls got these big-ass letters to spell somebody's name out. Where the fuck do the letters come from at the club? They just be coming out the back, you know, David. I tell you what, you've never been to a nightclub and seen a dude order one bottle and then call it a night. Nah, but then that dude got 5-6 bottles on his tab, and everybody thinks it's the bottle girls that make dudes want to order more bottles. No, it's not. It's the DJ. DJ's the mastermind behind it all, because as soon as the DJ sees that first bottle come out with that sparkling on it, DJ gets on a microphone, starts hyping that dude up, basically mind-fucking him, making him feel like he's the man that night, makes him want to pop more bottles, you know? Because as soon as that first bottle comes out, here comes the DJ. Oh, shit! I see you, table six! I see you, table six! One bottle, two bottle, three bottle, four bottle! Somebody getting it in tonight! Girls coming out the back, David. Every time I see a dude be popping bottles, I be sitting at the bar, my one drink, watching it all play out. So while the DJ's hyping David up, I'll be over at the bar doing the math. I'll be like, oh shit. David got the big bottles of Hennessy. That shit's $750 a bottle. So the DJ's going, one bottle, two bottle. I'm over going, $750, $1,500, $2,250, $3,000, $3,750. David gonna be mad in the morning. I mean, I be trying to tell dudes, man, you ain't got to pop bottles and meet girls like that. Because I think 9 times out of 10, guys go to nightclubs, it's to meet girls, I get it, you know. But if you ain't got $1,000 to pop on bottles, you ain't got to do it, man. I be telling dudes, man, if you want to meet girls, you ain't got the money like that, just listen. Just wait outside, wait for the club to close. Everybody got to leave, you know. You know, hopefully a food truck pulls up. It's so easy to meet girls at the food truck when the club closes. Because usually, the girls leaving a nightclub, when they wait to close, those girls are a little tipsy, discombobulated, got their shoes in their right hand, you know? They in the parking lot looking for the girls they came with, just walking around. Karen? Karen? Who the fuck is Karen? I be telling you, man, just wait for the food truck to pull up. Hopefully it's a taco truck. Everybody likes tacos late at night, you know? So when it's your turn, just wait in line. When it's your turn to order some tacos, look behind you, find a nice looking lady, offer some food. Just sit there. What's up?
Wait.
You want, what's up? Yeah. You want some tacos? You want some tacos?
I'll take a taco.
All right, get two tacos. Hey man, let me get two tacos, $2. Here you go, have a couple tacos. Girlfriends come over, where'd you get them tacos at? That dude right there, he nice. You want some guacamole on it? Let me get a side of guacamole, 50 cents. Here you go, put some guacamole on your tacos. You spent $2.50. You got the same phone number David got. David spent $6,000 popping bottles in a nightclub. You know?